The Battle of Shiloh was one of the bloodiest battles at the time and took the lives of many people. The Confederates had a surprise attack on the Union, but backfired when the Confederates backed off and the Union took over. The Battle of Shiloh was fought in southwestern Tennessee. Ulysses S. Grant was the leader of the North and also served as president from 1869 to 1877. Albert Sidney Johnston was on the Confederate side and died on the first day of battle. P.G.T. Beauregard served as a Confederate general. He ordered the first shots of the Civil War. Beauregard took over after Albert had died. Don Carlos Buell served as a Union Major General during the Civil War and played a key role in the Union victory at the Bloody Battle of Shiloh. The Union, which was the North, won. The cost of the victory was very high, and 24,000 people died. The North forced the Southerners off balance, and the level of violence shocked the North and the South. The Confederates could have won the battle, but they backed off from their surprise attack, leaving the victory to the Union. John Clem ran away from home after his mother tragically died from a train accident. He became a drummer boy for the Union Army and was later named the Drummer Boy of Shiloh. At the Battle of Shiloh, Clem demonstrated his calmness under fire. During the battle, a Confederate cannonball smashed Clem's drum while he was playing it. Clem was captured in the battle, but later managed to escape. His new nickname was Johnny Shiloh. Clem eventually settled in San Antonio, Texas, where he died on May 13, 1937. After 2 days of brutal fighting, nearly 24,000 people were dead, wounded, or missing. This battle made the nation realize that the Civil War would not end without many lives taken. Apparently, it is said that after Shiloh, the South never smiled again.